told me this interesting thing about this map or something like that. No, both of them, both Taz and MBK were like, oh, don't talk to me. I'm having a terrible tournament. I'm playing really badly. Yeah, so just don't mention me. It's like, oh, thanks for that.
Don't even bring me up.
You've really helped me there.
Here we go.
Pistol round, Titan on CT side versus virtus.pro, the EMS Katowice champions. Yeah, we will see virtus.pro make their push out. Now, Nade beautifully lands on three players, just takes away over 100 damage between them as Existence will just try to pick some players off from behind. It's going to be Scream retreating as he gets dropped by Taz. And there you go, not playing too badly as he goes through. Bomb has been planted on the A site, 4-on-5 after plant for VP to try and retake. Sorry, for Titan to try to retake as Kenny S will lead the first assault, joined by Smiths and Existence. They push in now. Smiths has got himself the frag onto Bialy, and it will be Kenny S to go in, but this is really into the firing line go. Existence with the smoke covering him is going to try and get in there, but MBK's been picked off the grenades there. Existence is still in there, though, and going to get the defuse through the smoke. Beautiful play from everyone else on Titan. They let him get in there, and then they just swarm. They're like, we're going to distract you. Look over here, look over here. No one looking at the defuser.
Big dreams there. Huge stuff. Yeah, so fantastic stuff. It looked like Titan were almost out of that. They kind of lost the first pick, and then bomb went down. It looked like Titan were kind of locked out completely, but very smart play there. So it's quite nice. He's actually utilizing all their smoke grenades, everything in their arsenal. Big defuse there, and I think virtus.pro will be a little bit disappointed that round, maybe frustrated, kind of questioning how that even was possible to happen.
But they were 5-on-3 at one point.
Exactly. So great stuff from Titan. That's exactly the start they needed for this CT campaign. I've always said that the CT side is sometimes a more challenging side, depending on what you prefer, but generally T is the favored side in this.
So as we flick through, you'll see those. What I love about the way that they've coded CSGO is now you see for each player semi-finalist at DreamHack.
It's nice.
You see the accolades just reeling off in the background. And it's like, yeah.
You know he's a big deal.
Yeah, for every one of these players. Yeah, I'm the big deal. Existence picks himself up the headshot onto Bialy, and he will now look for frag number two. Helps himself to it, and Titan get 5 unanswered frags and go 2-0 up.
I think, like we always talk about in CSGO, like the eco rounds being so strong now, but Mirage is actually one of those maps where it's so like long range, and like, as long as the CTs play correctly and don't do anything too silly, they will lock those rounds out quite comfortably. So I don't think we'll see any... Well, I say it now, hopefully we won't see any crazy ecos kind of spoil the economy. I know they're exciting to cast, but I like it when teams play properly and they kind of make sure they get 3 rounds in a row. I always like to see that. It makes me happy.
Makes your old sauce bones feel good.
Exactly, but we've got a full bite here. And Titan picking up the first kill there. It's going to absolutely be devastating to virtus.pro. They make their way under the site, but they have a couple of answers themselves, taking out Smiths and Scream. It looks like they'll be able to get the bomb down that A-bomb site.
Yeah, only that 3 players left up for... Titan as they make their way in. Bomb has been planted and Existence will get himself the frag onto Taz. We're down to a 3v3 and Kenny S coming from behind.
Whack 7.
Definitely, I thought Pasha heard him there as he came in, but no, Pasha will get engaged elsewhere and then get dropped. Kenny S will get himself that kill. It's Bialy, 1-on-3.
Nice.
Kenny S gets himself another one with that FAMAS. That's 2 frags for him, 2 for Existence, and the bomb defused. Titan pick up their 3rd round in a row, and we'll see whether VP in the end regret that buy.
Well, that's the thing. That's such a huge round for Titan there. We saw them have one player had a shotgun, they had the FAMAS out, and the fact you can take down 5 AKs in that kind of situation is fantastic. But one thing to note, they got the bomb down again, virtus.pro. So although they'll have to eco this round, they'll be able to have a full buy next round. I'll expect we'll see the AWP kind of come out in some degree. And that's when the game's going to start. Obviously, this is fantastic stuff for Titan, but we'll see virtus.pro get into this next round. Should be quite a clean up here for Titan.
On board with that Existence, and there's 2 men to him. So Kenny S with his weapon of choice will have those kills just kind of nipped off the edge of his toes, and VP being hunted down. But Bialy does get himself the kill onto MBK, and does get himself the AK as courtesy of it, leaves it for Neo, in fact. And Neo will watch as these players try to make that rotation over towards B site. Neo picked off by Existence, and that was a big moment there. If Neo could have got the kills, it would have opened up that site for a plant, but the bomb is actually nowhere near. It's Kenny S who gets himself the kill onto Bialy, and the bomb carrier, Snacks, is...
missing in action.
Yeah.
I think he had a master plan here, but obviously hasn't got his favor. He needed the guys to get at least 1 kill to cause that distraction, I think. I think right now he's going to be looking for a kill. I don't think he fancies the chance of getting the bomb down. He obviously left it way too late, and it looks like him. This is a shot there, kind of a rare sight to see from him. But I think it's Scream here. And that's going to put us to 4-0 in favour of Titan. Fantastic start for them here. Obviously, on the more difficult side. And I think this is where virtus.pro really needs to hit the gas on now. I think we can see Pasha not opting for the AWP here. He's going for another 5 AK setup. We can see
two on the other side, though. MBK picks himself up an AWP.
This is what to do. This is the best thing you can do with a CT. When you get the money rolling on this, the economy's on your side. You can lock down both bomb sides without the sniper rifles getting those early picks. It's really, really difficult for the terrorists to get back into it.
Here is Kenny S. will peek. One there for him to see. Neo will line up the nades, and there's Existence and Smiths both getting themselves a kill. Pasha and Snacks go down, and Existence just extending out and is now kind of controlling virtus.pro's destiny. He knows what is clear. He knows where they can't go, and will.
It's interesting though. Titan did that in the first gun round, and they've done the exact same thing. A virtus.pro falling for it again. Like, it shouldn't really be happening. The T's have got the advantage in that situation. They've got the pillars and the kind of angles to help them out. So great work from Titan to get those picks. Like, fantastic. That's a round one, just from one move.
And when you extend out that far, you get so much information as a result.
The intel is very invaluable. And then Kenny S should be able to clean up here. He's in a great position. There's not going to be many smokes left. I think virtus.pro will just want to get the bomb down now to kind of salvage this round a little bit. There's not really much chance of them getting back into the round.
Kenny S with the opportunity there to close this one out. Doesn't do so. And it was, gets his second bite of the cherry as Neo will go down. And last man standing is Taz. And Taz will go down fighting, but go down he surely will. The bomb is there waiting for him. They have no idea that he's there, though, as he's pushed up as far as he has. Finally, they will start to connect with some hits, and he will push out. Kenny S will get it.
Getting a very nice little lead here, aren't they? This is going very well for them.
And for Titan, I feel they need a bit of confidence. Titan need a win.
Definitely. But one thing I will know about virtus.pro, whenever I watch them play this map, they're such a stronger side on CT. They prefer the CT setup. I think they'll find their stride here. They just need to be able to post a few rounds to give them that chance to even get into the CT half. Like, if they continue the way they are, there's not going to have enough rounds to play with, and it's just going to be over before the second half even begins. So they definitely want to start picking up the slack here, locking out the ult with the smokes. I don't think they're utilizing smoke grenades enough. You can see Kenny S has all his freedom and vision of middle. He's got that information. They can just smoke off that mid area for him. He won't be able to get these kills he's getting like that.
Neo gets picked off, and Kenny S will lay claim to it. Snacks gets himself one back. We're at a 4v4, but Titan at the moment dominating the proceedings. As Kenny will push in, Smiths is going to wait for him, and will. Their virtus.pro look like they're going to round out to make their way into Kenny territory once again.
Hello.
Rattles off that shot, and will have scared the bejesus out of Bialy, who flashes over and forces Kenny back. So he sits and waiting for Bialy to show himself. Bialy's got to be tempted to push in.
They need to lock these AWPs down. They haven't got an AWP to take him out. They need to get something and get in the face of the flashbangs.
Switch over to Taz, Pasha, and they're going to put four players in towards that A site. Taz is the one charged with keeping their back clear, and MBK has been dropped, and that's one of the AWPers down and out. But there is Kenny S going for the second one, gets himself the frag onto Snacks, but not before he's down. So both AWPers out for the count. Scream, the last man standing. Surely virtus.pro with a bomb plant can finish this one off. Scream delivers an almighty headshot onto Bialy, but he's between a rock and a very hard place here, which he's coming out fighting to deliver. Pasha gets picked off, and now it's one versus one. Scream with 2 points of health against the veteran that is Taz, who surely will finish off the job.
Wow.
But he got close.
Man, that's where you got to be careful when you've got someone like Scream left in the 301. Never write him off. He can cause absolute havoc whatever situation he's in. You saw that crisp one taps coming in from him. I think had he just held the angle a little bit tighter to the box there, he would have had that. It was a great play from him, and unlucky he wasn't the victor there. But virtus.pro have arrived into the game. They've got the round, and I think that's definitely what they needed. You can see the economy's not great. They've had to opt for a Galil here as well. So they'll want to string some rounds together now. If they lose this round, it's going to be so important. As the money literally goes down the toilet, they'll be left with $1,400 each. So huge round now. They definitely want to make sure they string some together.
And look at Scream, pushing all the way up. You're talking this in the last round.
Yeah.
They've just absolutely no resistance to them in the middle. They're not using the nades to control that area, and they're getting a lot of information. But this time, no siree, as two frags come in, Smiths and Scream both picked off, and virtus.pro have been able to build up a little bit of a lead here with Existence going down. It leaves just MBK and Kenny left standing. MBK's pushed around behind, and Kenny's going to go through spawn and get behind that A site to try and get vision. But by the time he gets there, the bomb will be down. And he and MBK are going to have to choose.
It's a big decision here. Is it worth it?
Well, when they get there a frag like that, it's going to be so inviting. Two versus two, and MBK and Kenny S look to reclaim, but the bomb's already ticked for some way now, but Snacks has been dropped. Now it's a one on two. Can they get in there? As Taz and Bialy will look to hold this one back, and Bialy doing a perfect
here
job.
Here comes again.
And Kenny S goes in. Taz through the box, gets the finish onto Kenny. MBK going up against Bialy. Now they know exactly where Bialy is, but that wasn't enough. Bialy finishing off the job, holding this nerve, and virtus.pro win two rounds in a row.
Yep, absolutely. That's exactly what they needed. As I said before, their economy was absolutely screwed unless they got that round. Titans still able to buy here. They've got the AWP set up still. So I think this is game on now. This is where we can see virtus.pro string some rounds together and kind of get themselves right back into this. I think they definitely want to be winning this half. Like, as a T side, you realize it's kind of your aim. Kenny S there, gets the intel on the vision, but actually misses the shot. I think that's going to be him locked out of there. He's going to have to rotate back to B.
But that's fine from Kenny S's perspective.
Definitely. Like, if he can just call the team in middle, at least people know to look at connector and they can kind of take their focus off A so much, and then see Existence reacting to that straight away.
Existence will see Neo coming his way. Smokes aiding the VP side as they set up for an A entry. They're going to go on a 3-2 split to try and take on Existence and Scream, who are kind of in the middle of no man's land here until they get themselves set for this.
So close.
The smoke fades just in time for Existence to be set up and ready to go. And Snack somehow picks off the headshot before Existence can finish off the job. Scream now going to come in. He'll fire instinctively through the smoke in the direction of Bialy, but doesn't get it and loses 74 points of health in doing so. And Kenny S gets himself a kill onto Snacks, but again takes damage. We're a man advantage for Titan, but too low health. As the bomb is down, and we're at 3-on-4 after plot. As through the box, it will be Smith to try and take on Taz, who's on 58 points of health. And Taz has pushed up nicely and will nestle himself in.
Horribly wrong for Titan.
And Taz waits and strikes. First frag, doesn't get the second, but Pasha helps him out. MBK's gone down. It's Smith, who's already got two, versus Bialy, and he goes in. Bialy's got a bomb diffuser to carry about as well, but Smith's hat trick does the job, but no kit on Kenny S.
Gonna be close, he should have it. Oh no!
Oh, wow, that was so close.
No way, I thought he definitely had that. Unbelievable, that's gonna be really frustrating with Titan. After that fantastic retake and that great teamwork at the end, one defusing and one taking down the enemy, that's gonna be really annoying. Why haven't you got a kit? Oh no.
And the dead bodies that were around as well, surely there was a kit on the floor somewhere.
I think it was a forced buy, to be fair. And it's interesting, is that MBK taking out a scout? What's going on here?
Well, there's not. Yeah, they'll.
There's a scout coming out.
Scout power. Kenny S this time without the AWP as well. He's just looking, just takes the peek. Again, there's not much pushing him back, but Pasha is out there as well. Let's see. MBK's just sat on B long with that scout. And you've seen it work.
We've seen it work, definitely it's viable, well, more viable than it used to be.
But you could rush a scout so easily.
Yeah, but now, lucky you see, it's that kind of Call of Duty style jumping and shooting. That's what they've brought into the game recently, and that's why...
Oh, wow, you just made a PC Master Race comment there. Well, here at Gfinity, of all places...
apologies to anyone who is a Call of Duty fan, but shooting and jumping, that's why people buy it now. It's starting to come into the game, becoming viable.
I'm just not even going to go there. You just left the door wide open. We'll definitely have won some fans on HLTV.org there, so it's all right. As Scream sits in wait for Bialy. Titan look to hold on to this A side as the virtus.pro steamroller begins to move in. They've three rounds in a row, VP, and they are going to put the bomb down once again. And,
don't see them getting back into this. Maybe save the scout, MBK. Is it worth it?
Kenny S gets himself the frag onto Taz. There's a 3-on-3 here, so they may feel that they're obliged to go for this, given that fact. And you'll see MBK, he is the vision man from that position. He will be able to occupy Neo, but isn't able to kill Neo. But Neo is going to get in and stop Kenny S from getting that defuse. MBK gets two, but doesn't finish off the job. And Titan, a 5-4, that lead has been eaten away.
Yeah, it's just now I think we'll have to see the eco coming from Titan. You can see that they had the 5-0 lead, and that completely has dwindled. It's like, maybe they need to adapt their playstyle a little bit, kind of like they were doing it so well early on, getting those early frags and surprising the tees. I think once it started going wrong for them, they kind of fell back onto the back foot again, and then kind of found it difficult to get back into the game. And that questionable scout buy, I'm not sure whether that was intentional, but it's a very big move to make in such a high-level game.
Neo picks off Smith. Interesting point that in terms of mixing it up, from Virtus Pro's perspective, yeah, they just ran A until it worked.
Sure,
and every time they got the bomb plant quite quickly and then just sat in a good after plant situation. There are so many angles in that site.
Exactly. They were getting the bomb down and they were losing the clutches early on. I think they realized that. They can get into the bomb site, but as long as they can just coordinate themselves in the clutch situations, they can get rounds. It's getting the bomb down is half the battle. Once you do that, technically you have got the advantage of T's, the CTs have to come and swarm the bombsite and take it from you. But here we go then. Maybe we'll see a change of playstyle here. Kenny is getting back on the AWP. It'd be nice to see him change position a little bit here. I think he's been over at A so much. It'd be nice to see him go towards B, maybe get an early pick and then kind of surprise the terrorist a little bit more. But let's see what he's got in store for us this round. Oh, they're going for the house pick again. This has worked so well for them in the past.
But they didn't put the AWPer in there before. They do get it. Existence has been picked off though. And Scream and Kenny S get out of there. So a trade of players, but let's see who that in the end benefits. Losing Pasher is always a big, big loss. Stacks goes in and gets himself a frag onto Smiths. And we'll see VP now looking to add to that man advantage as MBK.
There's no CTs whatsoever on the B-bomb side now. It'd be difficult for them to think, like, is this round, is it worth it? We might as well save the guns here. We've got no one in B whatsoever. Retakes, it'll be next to impossible. Bomb actually coming in for the terrorist now. It'd be interesting. MBK's actually got himself in a very smart position, though. If he can get a frag here into the house, it could open the round up for Titan.
Great play from Tazzo, stopping his run.
Here we go. This is the frag right here. This is the frag. Who wins the round?
Oh, Taz gets it. MBK went left and Taz was right. And will be the end.
Always cover your flanks. That's the rule.
CS is won by the smallest of margins. A quote that if he were here today, our fallen Finn, he would be stating so regularly. You know, games are won and lost by just the smallest of battles.
Yeah, absolutely. And that frag right there, like I said, if MBK had got that frag, then it would have opened the round up for Titan. They could have coordinated that and got in there. But smart play from Taz, holding the sensible play, I should say, kind of making sure he's not looking for the frags or the glory shots on the window and stuff like that. He's kind of just making sure his team are covered and the whole map is locked out for them.
So 6-5 in favor of Virtus Pro. They've turned it around.
Yeah, this is great stuff. Great to cast backwards and forwards. So we saw 5 rounds in a row for Titan. Now we've seen 6 in a row for Virtus Pro. Hopefully Titan get back into this. They've dropped the AWP from Kenny S now, kind of opted for that rifle setup. It'll be interesting to see what they've got in store for them to kind of get themselves back into this. They've completely lost their momentum, and Virtus Pro is firing on all cylinders right now and kind of seems to be hitting all their shots.
On board with Scream, he's going to see Bialy and will get picked off by Bialy as Virtus Pro open up. Existence will have to deliver here despite the flash as he spies Snacks. And that's fine, let Snacks go. Snacks will say it's all clear and Existence can sit and wait for the bomb carrier. Oh, he's gone too early there. He had the opportunity to deliver something big, but as the bomb planter ran past the box, he shot and sacrificed a great position. Snacks pushes out, gets himself the kill onto Smiths, and it's just MBK and Kenny S who will retreat. No, MBK surrenders his life pretty cheaply there. Kenny S is out of there.
Getting from bad to worse for Titan. It was such a promising start as well. Virtus Pro showing why they're so dominant on this map, even from a 5-0 deficit. They got themselves right back into it. And right now, you wouldn't bet against them in the current situation, the way things are going. From like I said before, they're so strong on CT as well. It's going to find it difficult for Titan to get back into this one.
Now, what we haven't noticed in the 5 rounds that Titan won, it was Kenny S pushing into mid and just, you know, okay, we know where they're going from here. He got so much early round information. That hasn't happened.
Yeah, well, I'm not sure why, because from what we've seen from Virtus Pro, they haven't really been utilizing the smokes and locking out that information. Though Kenny S has been able to kind of spot middle at the start and kind of been given those jewels, but maybe hasn't been landing his shots in the last few rounds, but it seems like they're kind of caught up now. They kind of lost their ideas of how they can lock this terrorist side out. Maybe it'd be a case of kind of just sending one player to B now. It kind of seems like the Virtus Pro are obviously committing to that A bomb site so regularly that they just kind of need to make a bit of a gamble and kind of just say, okay, we'll keep one person in the B bomb site and stack towards A. And say that screen does open the fragging onto Bio.
And it's important as to where he got that frag as well. See how far he's already extending out, and he's saying, yes, it's right to have two players over on B. For the first time, Titan have two on B in this game, and they're going to need it. As they sit and wait. In fact, the bomb is going to pull back. And we'll see as VP sit a little uncommitted. Now they're going to make their move on towards B as Snacks is in there. Just trying to draw someone out. And it'll be Taz dancing with existence here on the entry to A.
Fragging up. Oh,
Taz gets it. 4-on-4. Now Titan, who probably thought they knew what was going to happen, are wondering, where on earth do we go? As VP have regrouped back on T-Spawn, and those two players in B no longer look like the smarter move.
Yeah, now you can see A, this looks like an absolute open area for Virtus Pro to take over, and they're going to be doing the A smoke down. I think Scream's going to be screaming for his teammates to arrive, because this is just him, 1-on-4 situation right now. We can see the CTs running in and instinctively shooting through that smoke, not a bit of fun much damage there.
But Taz 16 health, Neo 61, Pasha, here we go. MBK pushing in, gets himself two big frags. He's got one more to finish off the job, and it is going to be Neo or bust, and Scream will take it off his toes. And now they will get their first round in 7, as Titan pull us back to 6-7 there. And Scream, let's talk about the role there, because he could have given away a cheap kill if he went for the first one, but he sat back and was able to, those little shots did a lot of help.
I think he was more the diversion there, because we saw MBK kind of flanking him from the back, and he kind of played it so nicely there. Most players, when Scream and Corda coming up to the side, would start running. We saw MBK just walk so methodically around the corner, saw the first player, and knew exactly what he had to do. Got two kills, got Titan back into that round. I think he was the pivotal factor there. So amazing work from MBK, very smart play. And yeah, good work from Scream as well. Didn't give his kill away, and kind of acted as that distraction to give MBK the opportunity to even get that play.
7-6 the score. Of course, from Titan's perspective, if they were to win one and then lose one, it would hurt them.
Oh, definitely. But I think Titan have enough rounds to play with right now. I think they've done enough. Like, this half, if they lost the last two rounds, it wouldn't be too much of a big deal. Obviously, they want to win them. But right now, they've done enough. Anything I would say now is a bonus. Anything else. They're going to be happy with this half regardless.
Here come Virtus Pro. Existence gets picked off by Neo. Kenny S returns the favor with Pasha down and out. And we'll see the move in from Snacks as he will engage the three Titan players who are just waiting for him. Now the smoke covers them all. Taz gets himself the frag onto Scream. MBK and Smith both help themselves to one. Snacks is just passing silhouettes at the moment as he sits behind and is very soon about to find himself the last man up here, because it's only Bialy covering him as well. 2-on-2 here. They're distracted by Snacks, and Snacks has done beautifully here. He waited and waited and now has delivered a hat-trick of frags to win the round for Virtus Pro.
Fantastic.
Excellent work. It was the patience, it was the control, it was everything you've come to love from Snacks.
Yeah, absolutely fantastic play. More clever CS there, kind of making sure he waited for his opportunity to strike. Didn't like shoot too soon. It was great work from him, and you can see the buy now from Titan. Like you said before, they've won one, lost one. The scout is back on Scream. I thought the scout thing, for quite a few appearances this game, it seems. Maybe we missed something with the meta. But
how tempted are you in Snacks's position there, just to hold down fire and hope?
Well,
as soon as you hear something,
I think that's the difference between good CS players and fantastic.
And me.
Yeah, and you perhaps, but the fantastic ones know that they can get away with certain things, and you don't necessarily have to shoot the first person on the screen. So he did so well to navigate through the smokes and get himself into that position to win that round of hat-trick from him. Fantastic stuff. Classic Snacks.
So VP should go in 9-6 up at half-time.
Sure.
You said you were happy with that if you were Titan fan.
I'd say it's a CT, not necessarily as a Titan fan. If you're a CT, that's not a bad half, but when you're going up against Virtus Pro and you know how strong they are on CT, that's when you get it's going to be a trouble. Because from what I've seen them play, like they're such a stronger side on their CT. They really do just put up a wall. It's so hard to penetrate. But we can see here, it's going to be a 5-on-2 situation versus the Scout and Empire. I really don't see them doing much here. Kenny S did kind of
was desperate for a scout kill.
He's desperate. I think we all are. We want to see it now after all the hype has got. Here we go. Last round's going to finish up at 8-7 in favor of Virtus Pro. Yeah, great half. Very interesting half. Titan going up 5-0 and actually only managing to get one more round after that.
So from that perspective, very disappointing half.
Yeah, but I think if you told them before that you're going into the half, like if you CT, you can get 6 rounds. Okay, well, we can do
that. Oh,
Snacks. Oh, God. I'm a little bit of flair there to finish things off.
There is the Virtus Pro side who go in some 9 rounds to 6 up.
So around this pistol. Titan will be looking to get this. It'll be a case if we can just have a look at their spawns and see what they're doing. It'll be interesting to see what they buy. They've actually opted for the smoke grenades here, so like they're not going for the down the route of five times armor and some Glocks. They've got to take a more Molotov smoke of a bomb site perhaps and see what they can do. It's going to be nice little strategy coming in. Nice little, very Titan indeed. There's three in the window for VODS. Hunting out, seeing any information they can find on the map. It's all this about CT. You don't want to be caught with your pants down. You want to make sure you can get as much info as possible.
Pasha will be the first to engage, and he'll want a second bite at that cherry. And gets himself into a great position from behind that box, which is forced out by that Molotov. Kenny S gets himself the kill. Titan, man's advantage. Oh, two-man advantage. MBK dispatches of Taz as VirtusPro will retreat back in towards the... Oh, I was going to say retreat back in towards the A site, but they haven't done so. Snax has got himself the frag onto Neo and onto MBK, and now they'll push in looking for more. Neo is sat there, MBK dancing down in front of him, and we're on a 3-on-3 and still anyone's round.
Absolutely, it looks like they're kind of opting towards that B bomb site. We can only see one player actually there. Four titans for VirtusPro. It's going to be Snax. The Scream will be looking at his kill. Snax opens up. Bomb does go down. And now the CT just need to fall back and hold the bomb site. As I say that, who cares? Go for the frags.
Yeah, that's not VirtusPro style. Yeah, just get in there. Fall back.
I would be calling for everyone to fall back. Play the position. We've got the bomb down. But no, yeah, Snax going big there as usual. Great work from him. And that's going to be devastating to the Titan. They really did want to get that pistol to kind of get this campaign off to a good start. We can see the full rifle buy here, four Famuses and four VirtusPro. If we have a look at the Titan buy, they've got the option for those CDs, and they've actually got an array of armor and grenades as well, so they will actually be looking to win this round. They're going all in here.
A CZ onto B is not impossible on this map at
Definitely
all.
Not. Nothing's impossible with that gun, to be honest. We've seen so many crazy things happen in the last few years.
But onto the end of Neo's Famous goes MBK. Kenny S follows suit. Scream is going to go through, and it'll be VirtusPro with only two more Titan players to find. Existence, the last man standing for them. And he, behind that van, is not too subtle.
That's why I'm not a fan of the CZ buy, especially armor on this map. I just don't think it's the map to do it on. I don't really rate it, to be honest. Like, now they've just got themselves in an even worse situation than they were last round. I think they should have just taken the pistol loss in the chin and kind of just moved on and kind of aimed for the first gun round. Now they're going to find themselves just on the back foot and chasing the economy the whole time. That's really without dropping a kill as well. Like, CT is going to build their money up and probably keep those famices as long as possible, trying to build that economy and get that stronghold on the map.
You've played against many of these Titan players before.
Oh yes, many, many times.
MBK told me earlier he could count on one hand the amount of people who beat him in Source in that team. Were you one of them?
Definitely wasn't one of them. I took him to a ropes a few times. I never actually conquered them. I think I might have taken a couple of maps over the years, but they were always, especially Vera games, too strong in Source. They just really did just dominate that game completely.
Your encounters against VirtusPro?
No, actually. No, never had the pleasure. Like, I'd never played Go on a professional level, so never got to see it. Spectated of them a lot of times. I would love to get back in the arena and playing there this sort of level, but I think my days are done, unfortunately.
Too old?
Too old. 26 now. Gotta move on.
One foot in the grave there. Yeah. This is a methodical eco round from Titan.
Yeah, interesting to see the kind of... I think they'll just be aiming to get the bomb down here. They've got a flashbang in hand. I think you can see them kind of just waiting for their time. They're just going to burst out any second. Aim will just be to get the bomb down. That's all they'll be saying. You see that? Look, some running throughout the side. They know no kills are happening here. We've got Existence left on 2 HP. I don't really know what he's planning on doing here. If he can get one frag of the block, he'd be happy. But, if we can take a quick look at the frag charge, I don't think we've actually checked in yet. Let's just see who's dominating the board. Kenny S actually leading the charge for Titan on 20 frags. We can see Neo and Taz on 16 and 14 frags there. Kind of evenly spread out on VirtusPro. Kind of a big team effort there. No one really slacking behind. So this will be the first interesting round of this half, I believe. So we can see Neo actually picking up the AWP and seeing what he can do with it.
Massive round for Titan here, because if they lose this, they are staring down the barrel of defeat after their eco. As Snax will pick himself up that frag onto Kenny as the top fragger, as he'll push in. Existence returns the favor, chasing out. Snax kills Snax with that Molotov, and that's a big advantage there for Titan. Now 4-on-3 can reset and see if they can finish this one off, but Pasha will help himself. Existence goes down. So Pasha went searching. Smith is going to have to come and rejoin the group here as we're set for a 3v3. From this position, how do you set yourself up?
Well, the CT is obviously going to be a bit spread out. It's in favor of the terrorist here, having to, this group having to choose a bomb site. The CTs have to spread themselves out. As we see here, the Smiths opening up the fragging, MVK one of his own, and it's going to leave Neo in a very difficult situation indeed. I really don't see him getting back into this. Great round for Titan there, good play, good early frag as well, and that's exactly what they needed to get themselves back into this after that kind of early deficit of buying up of the CTs.
Yeah, they're on the board now for the second half. 12-7 in favor of virtus.pro. Still a lot of Counter-Strike to be played in this one. And both teams needing a win, having both dropped games earlier on in the tournament.
This group's looking very interesting indeed. Both going to be hungry for a win, just to kind of secure themselves. I know four teams go from the group, but you don't want to let anything slip here. Like, it'd be so devastating if they don't get through. So both teams playing, no love lost whatsoever.
But we were saying to MBK earlier, you know, part of us now wants Titan to go out so MBK can come and cast.
Oh, really? Does everyone love his casting that much? You kind of just want to get rid of Titan so he can come join us.
I would never confirm that statement, nor would I deny it.
Kenny S here, the man with the sniper rifle, looking. This is what he's so good at, walking into bomb sites by himself and seeing what he can do. On this occasion, looks like a whole lot of nothing because he gets knocked down to 34 HP. That's going to kind of take him out of the round, and I think he's going to have to fall back now. 1 minute left on the clock, and they're Titan have to decide where they're going to execute next.
And perfect play from the man in B, just absolutely scared them more than anything else.
Just knocked them back, it kind of just shook them up a little bit, wasn't it? Like, Kenny has knocked to 30 HP, he's going to take him out of the round almost. So the time's going to be ticking away, and I think Titan are going to be a bit shook up here, what they can actually do.
On board with Neo, who... we'll be surprised that he hasn't seen action just yet. Pasha gets himself a kill onto Scream as Neo will push out, and it's going to be Existence next to see action. He gets himself the return onto Pasha. Kenny S now in that site is looking for the man coming from spawn, but MBK and Existence have done his job for him. It's only Neo and Snax left standing against three. Smiths, MBK, and Kenny S. And that will be Snax in on MBK, but Neo was picked off just before he could finish. What can Snax do? 44 points of health against about 100 over two men as he will make his way in now. They know exactly where he is as they make themselves hard to find, and Snax is going to jump in and pick himself up another weapon with more ammunition as he dances in towards that site. And has two in his spawn area as he pushes across now, goes for the first frag, gets Kenny S. Can he finish off the job? Last man is Smiths, who's now running for his life. Snax is going to go across. No, he's not going to have enough time, and just Smiths just did enough.
Just being the operative word there, I think. Like, the fact Snax actually managed to get that much damage off on him, I think that's a slightly sloppy clutch play from Titan. Seemed like a lot of overfacing there when they were both stuck on the bomb site. I think they needed to force him more into a position where he had to defuse. But Snax seems just so strong on those clutches right now. Very smart play. The fact he managed to pick up a kill there and do damage and get away was like great work from him, to be honest. Like, he did fantastic there. So,
from Titan's perspective, though, plan A didn't work going in towards B, and they were able to make the plan B work.
Yeah, well, it looked like virtus.pro got caught a little bit surprised there, and it kind of that's going to frustrate them a bit. Obviously, we can see them now being forced onto the eco, and it may be time for Titan to get back into this, pull some rounds back, and I think we might see this go to 12-12. I think this might be the moment where Titan have found out, they've felt out the CTs and how they're playing, and I think this could be it. This could be the comeback we've been kind of waiting for.
Here we go. Titan with a little bit of confidence now.
I think they found their footing on this half. They've won a few clutches, got the confidence up.
And very similar to the way virtus.pro got themselves back into the game. Yeah. Expensive rounds in terms of kill count, but it doesn't matter if you win the rounds.
Absolutely. That's the game.
Distance pings in an A, drops Neo down to 27 points of health, and then finishes off the job, helps himself to the frag onto Pasha as well. That is vintage Existence. And now he will fall back. We're in a great position here for Titan. They've made sure that on what is an eco round for VP, they've given away nothing. Snax gets himself the kill, and it'll be just Taz left standing, bomb to go down in a professional play from Titan to finish this one out.
Yeah, nice clinical stuff there, and making sure they got the frags they needed. Don't rush the bomb plant, especially when the team are underneath. You never know who's hiding on that bomb site. So they made sure they cleared the bomb site out first. Good work from them. And like I said before, I think this is them getting back into this game. It's going to be difficult for virtus.pro to hold off these rounds, especially when they're not buying up the orbs. We saw that the dual orbs being used throughout the day, and that's kind of the meta right now for CT side of Mirage. And we can see the five M4s here. I think they're gonna struggle slightly, especially with the likes of Kenny S running around. If he can find form on this map, he's going to be such a nuisance for them. Nice little smoke there. Good work.
That'll allow Smith to move out. You can courtesy of our excellent observer.
I was going to say, well, fantastic cameraman.
You can see exactly what that's enabled Smith to do. He gets in position. Interestingly, from VP, different to the successful Titan CT rounds, VP haven't been that interested in pushing out and grabbing that much intel.
Not yet. I think that's yet to come. I think they know they've got the lead right now. They don't need to do too much. It's crazy as I say that existence. Maybe they do need more intel. It looks like they've got no idea what's going on right now. As Titan swarm the bombsite and just kill everything in their path, and that's going to leave Snacks alone. I don't really know how virtus.pro had no idea they were in that position. That was absolutely unbelievable. But maybe this is what we need to see them now. We need to see a change of player methodology. We need to see virtus.pro get on top of this map and get that mid control and make sure they're getting the intel at the start of the round.
I mean, VPR classically a team who will just back themselves to get out of any problem with just pure aim.
Absolutely.
But when you're coming in at a 90-degree angle on someone looking at the other side, there's not much you can
do. Well, we might need a little bit more intel on this map. Like, something's missing here. Yeah, I think they need to get the AWP out. I think they need to get that AWP rolling. Challenge at the start of the round, even though they're not getting the kills, if they can just get the call off as to what's going on and where the precedence is with the terrorists, then they can start rotating and calling whether they need to fall back someone back from B or kind of stack that middle area to try and get the frag. But
now, when we looked at the scoreboard at halftime, Kenny S had 20 kills.
Yes.
Kenny S still has 20 kills.
He's been quite quiet, hasn't he? Like, you'd have thought when he's picking up the AWP on this side, you'd have thought this is when he'd come into his own. But to be fair, they're winning rounds. You can see Existence of Scream picking up two apiece there. And I think Existence has been fantastic this half. He seems to be getting all the frags in like at least two rounds, what we've seen so far. And he's slowly creeping up the scoreboard and catching up with Kenny S. But I'd like to see them utilize that AWP a bit more. We can see another eco here from virtus.pro. It'll be interesting to see what they have in store. Like, I'd like to see something like a bit more aggressive than the kind of just normal kind of 2-1-2. Like, nice to see a stack somewhere kind of actually trying to predict where Titan will be going.
And this is a moment when an in-game leader earns his salt, really, because you've done the supposedly the easy part of getting yourself to 12-12,
yep.
And now anyone can win. You've got such a short period of time to make the right decisions.
Absolutely. Well, this is where callers come into their own. This is where great callers are made. If they can kind of navigate their team to get these big rounds and kind of make sure they don't make any mistake. These rounds are the most important ones, in my opinion. If you throw these eco rounds away, like that's when you become a bad team leader. When you do silly mistakes like this, like. But you can see Titan actually approaching this so slowly, like it's almost like a gun round. They're waiting for the CTs to make the mistakes. They know they have to get into this round, so they're just holding back, keeping the distance, and this is like perfect stuff. And MBK pick up another frag here, and I don't think we'll see much reaction there. We just see Titan not even doing anything. They've got the advantage there. They don't want to give anything away, so this is looking really promising from them. They've kind of edged this half really strongly, and hopefully they can keep this up.
Nice. There you go. They do close it out. You comment on not throwing away pistol rounds, and it's eco rounds, and it's actually, you know, a fascinating part of CS:GO that makes it exciting. That as a saving round, you can believe you can go and win it.
Yeah.
But so few teams just close it out in the style that we saw Titan do. I know Dignitas commenting on it with Devilwalk in their Face It Cup. Dignitas were brilliant at giving away no cheap rounds.
Sure.
But you can't say that of many teams at the moment.
Yeah, I think it's like, especially with the new guns, and it's like the game's evolving almost every week. People are finding new ways to use the pistols and utilize them. It's like there's so many surprising things you see from them. Oh God, as we say that, Neo going absolutely aggressive here. Frag a piece for either team.
Well, this was what you called. You said they needed to get the AWP out. You said they needed a bit of aggression, and they have delivered. And they've gone for Snacks, getting an AWP and killing Kenny S as well. Suddenly, virtus.pro have come out with the big guns, and they get themselves another one. Pasha downed, but Taz avenges, and they still hold that man advantage. Only momentarily, though, as Existence gets himself another two for this round, as Taz is down and out. It's Existence and MBK versus Snacks and Neo, both with AWPs.
This is not a good retake situation. If Tyson get the bomb down here, that's pretty much round one.
Look at the position of the bomb.
God, what's he doing up there? What's that happened?
And that's the problem MBK faces. He's got to get up those stairs. Both AWPers on low health. Both AK is on low health. Neo gets himself the kill onto Existence. And now it's all MBK with 40 seconds to go. One on two. And he will enough to take the untakeable, which is a bomb perched about it. 2 feet above him in the air.
Creative counter-strike needed here if he's going to get this bomb. CTs, you know, they've got the perfect positions here and there's nothing to do about that. So it's great positioning there. And they opted to, like I said before, this is what they need to do to get back into this game. The double AWP set up and kind of dominate the map. 5 rifles, yeah, sure. If you're pushing, it works. If you're holding back, terrorists are going to beat you with those AKs. So now they're going to find themselves, I think, virtus.pro could close this out now. They can keep this set up with the double AWP and kind of have the opening frags. This is it now. This is them locking it out. This is where I've seen them be so strong online. It's getting the AWP on Pasha especially, and he seems to dominate completely on this. So this could be where virtus.pro come into their own on this half.
Well, let's see what whether the prophet that is Henry G can come true. You called it going to, almost 12-12. Let's see whether that follows through. MBK will go a long way in towards that site before being... Well, hasn't been fired at, and he will push in looking for Neo there, and will go a long, long way and get the frag. Neo will be fuming that he was able to go all that way. And MBK's frag was returned by Pasha as Existence gets picked off. Bialy follows suit as Titan find themselves a man to the good. Taz will return the favor, and Kenny S goes down. We're at 3-3. Billet Smiths and MBK left alone as MBK gets himself the return onto Pasha. It's Taz now trying to get into that site, but he can't, at courtesy of Smiths and Snacks. 1-on-2. He can do this. He's definitely a man that does not fear this situation. He's up against 22 health on Smiths and 94 on MBK. Pushes around the corner, looks for MBK, waits for him, finishes him off, and now he should surely finish off the job. Smiths is somehow still standing, and Snacks, trying to make himself hard to hit, delivers the frag and retains the round. From a 2v1 though, Titan was split all over the place at that point.
This is a fantastic move from Snacks. Such smart play. Like, as we've seen that from him so many times this game and generally in his CS career. But when you can see him in a 2-on-1, like, you just think, oh, he's got this somehow. He somehow gets himself in those positions where he gets the advantage. And it looked like he completely pulled Titan apart. And that's going to be really, really devastating to him. Like, you can see now, 14-11 is not looking good. This round is obviously vital. Kenny S really does need to go bigger. We've got 2 AWPs on Titan now. Strange setup to run on T side, perhaps, but I think they know they just need to do something drastic to get themselves back into this.
Could you be critical of Titan and say it was theirs to lose and they lost it at that point?
Well, definitely. If you're 2-1, like 2-1, it's definitely yours to lose. Snacks, though, I don't take anything away from him. He like did so fantastically there. Like, great movement and like kind of made the round his own. As we say this, we've seen a couple of kills come in for Titan.
Snacks pushes out, gets himself the frag onto Smiths. It was Kenny S that they wanted, and Kenny S did get away. Double AWP round this from Titan. MBK and Kenny S both landing a kill with theirs, and we see Titan fall back. Snacks has just 8 points of health, and Bialy's taken damage too. Man up for Titan, and they're in the last chance saloon here with VP on 14. They had to do something bold, and well, double AWP response was a bold response.
Oh, very bold indeed, but sometimes you need to roll out the big potatoes, and that's what they've done.
Roll out the big potatoes. I thought you were going to go with like roll a hard six or something like that, but no.
No, it's a new one. It's one of my own. I'm trying to make it a thing.
Well, it is a thing now. As Kenny S will lead the charge for Titan as they move in towards that A site now, and he will cover the position that it's normally Neo who comes across from, and he isn't there. Bialy is on the stairwell, and Neo is now going to make that movement in as Bialy and Snacks both get themselves a kill. Bialy and that Famous doing very, very well. It's a headshot onto MBK, and Kenny S is now isolated all the way back up. And from a man advantage, they're now at a two-man disadvantage. Kenny S is going to have to save out that AWP, and will maybe be challenged by Neo, but he's manned up to that. 4 match points here for Titan, for virtus.pro.
Let's have an interesting look at the money situation here. It's not going to be a great buy for Titan on this match point situation. virtus.pro, money's not great for their camp as well, but I think we know like they want to close this out now. This is the round. If they're going to do it, this is the one. We can see there's not much in terms of grenades and stuff on the T's. I assume they're going to kind of go towards that A execute they've been doing. It seems like it's been working for them, but let's see how it pans out. Bomber is actually towards B right now, kind of maybe just feeding out the map. I believe Kenny S will be looking to pick somewhere, see what he can do. Kenny S really does need to open this round up. Here we go. Looking for anything he can, any opportunity there the CTs will give him, he will take it.
If he gets the kill, he'll force the attack to force the defense to come over towards that A site, and that will just open it up for them on B. But at the moment, he's sat a little more passively than you'd expect for that type of a strat. And, it'll be screen to boost up. Kenny S gets himself the kill onto Pasha. Off camera there as he'll now wait. I think Pasha must have gone walking and looking for that kill, but now Kenny S will push out as he makes his move in towards the side. He's got two to his left if he can find them. And he does find them. What a hit onto Bialy. And this is Titan right back in this game here. As Snacks now 1-on-4 gets the first. And I tell you what, if it were anyone other than Snacks, we'd be saying it's all she wrote. But there is no way he can do this.
The monster.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, it's not going to go in his favor here. But that was exactly what Titan needed. They needed Kenny S to step up there, and we can see his frags now slowly increasing for this half. Man, I think he's found his form of the AWP, and he seems to be landing the shots and kind of like just doing his thing. That's what he does. He walks into bomb sites with absolutely no fear whatsoever. He doesn't even need backup from his teammates. No one seems to flash him in. He does his own flashbangs, his own smokes, and kind of just works to pick himself. Managed to pick up two that round. And that's going to force virtus.pro onto almost a full eco here. They've got a couple of CZs in hand, and looks like Taz has actually got armor. Interesting buy from him. But it'd be interesting to see how this round pans out. This is one, obviously, Titan can't afford to lose. They'll need to approach this exactly the same way they've approached every other gun round. Don't give anything away. Don't even give a frag away. You need all the money you can get right now. And so this is a huge, huge round.
And with those CZs in play, Kenny with that AWP has to hit.
Yeah,
they need Kenny to open up.
It's interesting, the CZ is so much more powerful than CT. It's all about holding angles and seeing what you can do by holding these little cubby holes and stuff. Mirage has so many of the CT available. NBK opening up the fragging onto Taz, and that should be enough, hopefully, to get Titan into the ground and secure this one.
Yeah, Kenny hasn't been able to find anyone to connect with on that AWP. He gets just a pixel running across his screen there and doesn't do so as they'll fall back. The frag without any damage returned from MBK. Snacks down to 4 points of health as well. Existence looking to get himself in on the action too, as he misses an opportunity on Bialy, but to call it an opportunity is generous. As Titan, if they can convert this one out, will be just two rounds away. And draws, remember, are possible. We are in the group stages, and we have had one already today, as Smiths will make the charge in. There is one player left behind, and Smith should see him, does do so. MBK outed by Neo there as Kenny S pushes in, gets himself a point blank hit onto Neo and isolates that threat. And that leaves Bialy and Pasha left standing. They'll make their way in. Kenny S shoots loaded a little too early and will force the retreat, but Pasha's not even interested. He's got himself an AK and that'll be enough for him. And Bialy's wondering whether he can just get an exit kill. And if not, 15-13 the score. Two rounds to go. Where's your money?
I don't know. I think virtus.pro will close it out. I think this next round they're gonna. This is. I'd be calling right now. I'd be saying like, let's do something really audacious. Let's kind of throw something in their face they're not gonna expect. You get the full buy in your hand and you kind of take the risk and you kind of push. It's when you're pushing up middle, or you're sending the AWP somewhere. Maybe send the AWP to B at the start of the round. Kind of just get that information. Oh God, look at the money though. They haven't really, their options are very limited right now. Do they opt for another eco here?
Well, a draw's not a bad result, remember.
Yeah, but Stu, you don't want to draw. No one wants to draw, Stu. Come on. No one does that. You want to go for the wins. I think
at 15, they've got nothing to lose at that point as well.
Definitely. Well, this is it. Well, they've made the smart decision here. They've kind of kept their money healthy, and they've got to go for the win next round. So they've got the AK in hand and head armor on Pasha. With someone like Pasha with that gun in hand, anything could happen. Like, if he gets the opening frag, It's all better off. So let's see what happens here. Titan have to be so careful these rounds. Every kill is so vital. They need to make sure they take it so effectively and not give anything away.
In go those nades towards that A side as they will follow it up with MBK leading the assault once more. How deep will he go this time as he pushes in? Is going to try and escort in, but Pasha gets himself the kills onto Existence, and MBK's job was to guide Existence in, and he didn't quite do it. Sorry, it was Smith, and he didn't quite do it. Bialy's in there. We're losing men left, right, and center, but it's VP who are a man to the good. Kenny S is still going. What a hit onto Neo. It's Snacks 1-on-2, and Snacks is going to look for a gun on the floor. He will get one as well, and so this isn't over at all. Kenny S is on a hat-trick, has a hat-trick. Can he get the fourth? As Snacks will try to stop him. Kenny S needs to get that bomb down and allow that distraction to be there and just bring another dimension into this round. He does exactly that, and Kenny S will sit on that bomb like a goose on her egg. He'll push in. He's done some damage to Kenny S. He's on 57 points health, but Snacks only on 37 is health. And look at MBK. We've not mentioned him. He's out of sight, out of mind at the moment. And Snacks knows he is not going to get that.
Well,
and
we saw how bad the money situation is in the Virtus Pro camp right now. I think that's a wise decision for him. We've seen him clutch so many times, but very wise and informed decision. He kind of said to his team, look, we need as much money as we can. I can drop this next round. Potentially we can bring the Orcs that are back out if I can keep this gun. So that's what he's done. And this is obviously the round. This is make or break right now. Are Virtus Pro going to take this all the way and get the 16-14, or will Tice a bit of claw back into the game and bring it to 15-15? But a fantastic game to cast so far. How do you see this last round going down?
Up going Titan.
Yeah?
They've got the wind in their sails. They're singing that MBK, you are the wind beneath my wings, is what they're actually singing in French in there. I can hear it from here. They do look a bit of One Direction, so,
It's a boy band in there.
Yeah.
Personified.
Oh, Kenny S. You know, you talk about moments that win rounds or win matches. That might have been one of them, but wasn't an easy shot regardless. Such as the high expectations that rest on Kenny S's shoulders, who could be on a 30 here, as the nades will come in from Titan once again towards that A site. What can they do? What can Virtus Pro do differently to prevent this, as Taz is being pushed out of his position and Pasha will come in. MBK does get the first frag onto Bialy, but there's a lot of confusion raining on in that site. Smith is going to get down before he can get a kill as the bomb is planted, and we're at 4-on-4 after plant, but not much health on two players on that Titan side, and now we're down to just two alive. Kenny S, though, still to play his hand, and he's going to have to play it soon. Nice. He's the last man standing. Gets a hell of a hit onto Snacks. Gets up with one onto Pasha.
Oh!
Can you believe it?
Huge.
Kenny S delivers in style as he will pull Titan back from the precipice of defeat to save the draw for Titan. And it will be 15-15. Kenny S, take a bow.
Wow. He really woke up towards the end of that half. Unbelievable stuff from Kenny S there. What a round to finish it on. That's got to be the game of the tournament so far. That was absolutely fantastic.
And look at the reaction from Virtus Pro. They look like they've lost that game because it was theirs. It was just they were one frag away.
3-on-1 situation. Oh, man, that's going to be gutting for them. But Kenny S, here he comes. Great stuff.
Here we go.